run until like 2:10 or something.
Yeah. I was going to...
A lot of people call
What are we waiting for? Okay. Anyone who wants to leave at this point is free to leave. Anyone who wants to stay will gather around the tables and let's create some one or two fulcrums that you can use with partner to help deepen that sense of energetic grounding through the body. Why don't I just take one more moment to distinguish chemical energy. For example, a chemical potential energy that I would use to study a laboratory experiment in a chemistry lab, like on a fuel cell or in a test tube. Distinguish that kind of external chemical energy from internal alchemical energy. It's just the kind of energy that we control just through our own somatic awareness in our body. And that's the distinction to my mind between alchemical energy and that kind of control of the body energy internally and using our inner sense of awareness versus an external, in some cases more artificial, like chemical energy. We can certainly think of chemistry as governing biochemistry or body, but remember, what's going on in my body happens inside my body, and what goes on in a chemical laboratory goes on in a chemical laboratory. Some people sometimes confuse the inside of the body with a laboratory, just because we can use these techniques to understand everything that stands for the record, but it's a different sense of inside to feel that connection. So, let's go to the tapes. Describe the sensations in your body at all? Yeah. You almost feel me pulling the energy and letting it go into the ground for you. I'm still trying to figure out what the heck this thing is. I learned there's a couple introduction textbooks for balancing. It's one system among many for structural integration. Why don't you step off? All right, hey, Jamie, you want one? Get your shoes off. Well, then I want you to meet one.
Oh, yeah.
And then once we've had three demos, then people can try it. And they can come on, grab as well. You can scooch up. There. So just to make energetic contact to begin with, just kind of sense the feet and the ankles. And then scoop underneath, lift the heels. You're going to make contact with just the edge of your palm and the back of the heel around the calcaneus and the talus joint, if you know some anatomy. And you can landmark a little bit, keep a look in around the balls of the ankle with these three fingers on the inside. They have two fingers on the outside here, like so. Lift gently, and then ground into the ground, and just come to a sense where you can feel a little bit of the elasticity of the body. And you can feel the body's like, okay, we're stopping there now. And then just lean back and kind of curl the hands, and just pull a little bit. And you'll feel that heel just to gently adjust. It's like you're creating a little bit more space between the heel bone and the rest of the body. How's that, Jane? Great. Okay, let me go. And then you can, if you want, just go a little deeper. There. How's that? And, you know, from a medical perspective, this is just gentle traction. You know, the medical doctor says, what the hell are you doing? This is just gentle traction. And it's so good for the body. Very simple effect. Gosh, do you want to try demo one more?
Yeah.
Here, let's, because I can use one after all. And this table's wobbly. That table there, that's a zero balancing table. This is a standard massage table. That's a specially designed acupressure table. See, it's got more support, so it's designed for those extra portions on the table. Whereas this one's wobbly, if people want to play with it too afterwards, you'll see there's a big difference.
Okay, for sure. All right. So, How's that?
Great work.
Good idea. Drink lots of water.
passing beads around.